Chicago, Illinois is the site for this AFC North versus NFC North matchup between the Steelers and the Bears. We got a crossover conference game about to kick off here. Any thoughts before kickoff, Phil?
Well, these two teams don't know each other very well. So when you don't know the other team real well, you know what happens? You get surprised. A lot of big plays. This will be fun to watch.
Steelers setting up here for the kickoff. Hester's got a chance to return this one. No one's going to get him now. He's at the 50, the 40, the 30, the 20, the 10. No stopping him, taking it all the way home for the touchdown.
You always tell the kick returner, when he's in the end zone, don't take it out. This time he does. Look at the blocks. Look at the speed and the moves, and takes it all the way for over a 100-yard touchdown.
The Steelers set to return the kick. That'll be a touchback, and the ball will be placed at the 20. Ben Roethlisberger takes a look down from under center. Tight ends in motion here. First and 10. Bell's got it on the handoff. And that's a big-time tackle that keeps them 3 yards short of the first down marker. The Steelers come out. Two tight ends on the field. Second and 3. Roethlisberger sells the play fake and looks downfield. Breaks away. In on the stop.
When the offense crosses the 50-yard line on defense, you have to be careful now, because it gives the offense a little confidence. And what they're going to do here, they're looking for the big play down the field for that quick score. So on defense, you better play safe.
First and 10 as they go ground here, trying to establish the run, but there's nothing there here at the start.
Well, they didn't pick up many yards that time, no doubt about it, but that's a bad job by the running back. He picked the wrong side to run to. Nobody was blocked from the side he went to. Well, I know it was a short run that time by the offense, but it's what it's going to do for you long term. Keep running that football, try to wear the defense down.
Bells, the receiver, sent out wide to the left. Third and 6. And he's taken down.
Well, it's all about timing. I got to tell you something. The safety did a wonderful job timing the snap count that time. Caught everybody off guard, and he gets the sack on the QB.
Ben Roethlisberger takes a look down from under center. They fail to convert here on fourth down.
Well, I'll give the defense some credit here. They stopped them on fourth and long. Well, they should. Take that back. I'm not giving them any credit. I'm giving the blame to the offense. Bad decision.
First down coming up. To the ground here. They pounce on him there.
Well, when you talk about edge players in the NFL, it means play on the edge, rush the quarterback, and stop the outside runs. How about that play by the defensive end?
Midway through the first. Throwing now to his left. Catches made.
How do you stop these receivers now? It's almost impossible with the rules of the game. Tight coverage. That time they have double coverage on him. It doesn't matter. The throw comes. They go up. They make the catch. All you can do is raise your arm and go, well, we did our best.
To Marshall. And it's out of bounds, incomplete. Matt Forte lined up in the backfield. He'll fire it out to the left. The pass is intercepted. That brings the play to an end.
Most NFL linebackers, they're borderline good enough to be a running back, and they got the hands of defensive backs. Here's a good case. What a fine catch on the interception by the linebacker.
Browns in the slot. First and 10. Looks to his left. Caught. Tackled down at the 22.
Well, I guess the best thing to say there, Jim, is they completed the pass, but it still did not get a first down.
Pass complete, but did not get them the first, so it's second down now.
25 on that play.
Well, it doesn't look like much, but it really serves the purpose. Picks up the first down, and now they have a chance to open things up.
That was a big gainer. Now it's time to back it up.
Under pressure and incomplete.
Offense lines up here. Second and 10. The throw to the left. Throws a strike.
Good job that time by the quarterback. Man-to-man coverage down the field. When you see it, you've got to be accurate with the football. He was that time, and that's why we got the completion.
Let's see how they back up the big play here.
Oh, and almost picked off that time.
Quarterback was under a lot of duress on that pass, and alas, it's incomplete.
Listen, I know he was under duress, but you got to hit these type of throws in the NFL. You're not always going to get perfect protection. That's not a good job by the quarterback.
Play number 6 coming up on this drive. Looking for a receiver on the left side here.
Intercepted!
That was a terrible throw by the quarterback. When you're off target like that, you deserve to throw an interception.
Hester's going to get set in the slot for this snap. Going across the middle.
How did he drop that?
Look to football in. With the gloves these receivers wear, the rules that you can't touch them, there's no excuse for dropping the football.
Matt Forte lined up in the backfield. Looking for an open receiver on the right. And he's brought down right at the 43.
It's always good when your quarterback is able to deceive the defense with good play-action fakes. That's what did it that time. Look at the quarterback. Nice fake. Defense reacts to the run, and now you throw it over the top for the easy completion.
First and 10. Eyeing that left side. Drops the pass.
Well, he dropped the football, and there's no doubt why he dropped it. You have to look it in.
And here we have second down.
Get ready.
Looking to scramble. He's got a little bit of daylight here. Now they take the football onto the opponent's side of the field.
Well, good job that time by the defense. Getting pressure on the quarterback, but you can't let him break the pocket. Look at this time. He breaks the pocket. He's looking down the field. Nobody open, so he decides to run and picks up some big yards. Zone defense doesn't work in the NFL like it used to. Good job by the quarterback reading that zone and finding the open guy.
In the red zone. 15 minutes down, 45 minutes to go. Back after this word from your local station. Play number 6 coming up on this drive. And the second quarter is balls on the ground. This one's going back the other way. The defense comes up with the big play. The hit, and the recovery of the football.
They sure did. They got so much speed on the defensive side, and that speed, when you think about it, it gets more people around the football. It helps you deliver the hit even harder, and that's why they got the turnover. Great job.
That ball has been picked off. Nice tackle.
Anytime you're backed up on the offensive side, the quarterback's got to be extremely careful, because if you turn it over, you're just giving points to your opponent. That time, a bad decision by the quarterback, and he throws an easy interception for the defense.
Now on first down, the handoff to Matt Forte. He's got room. Good job on the ground there by Matt Forte.
That's a nice job blocking by the offensive line, and a really good job by the running back. Seeing the proper hole, gets up in there and picks up big yards.
He'll go left. Chicago in for the score.
That was a good job on that touchdown that time, and I tell you, there's nothing like being on top of the other team and make them chase you.
Makes the PAT. Bears ready to kick the football. They'll take it at the 20. It's first down as they head to the line. Has it. And James Anderson is credited with that tackle.
Well, that time the offense fumbles the football, but the defense hit him so hard, there's no chance of hanging on. Hits the ground and the defense recovers.
They come to the line of scrimmage. First down. Forte's taking the handoff. A tackle behind the line.
Good job by the defense. They stopped the offense that time on first down. Now the defense is in a good situation.
Second down now. Play action fake. Looking to throw. And he hauls it in. He's brought to a halt.
If I'm on the defense and the offense is this close to scoring, I'll tell you what I'm doing. I am sending everybody. I am going to gamble that it is a run. If they have the courage to throw it, let them. If they do, of course it'll be a touchdown.
Third and goal to go from the two. He is in for the touchdown.
Well, that's really having deep belief in your offensive line, isn't it? Third and goal, your offensive line just road grades the defense out there, and they get the touchdown running the football.
Robbie Gould ready to kick it. It out to about the 27 before he's taken down. Bells lined up in a single back formation. Got a little screen set up here. He'll be taken down about 3 yards short of the first.
Well, when you keep chipping away with these short throws, sooner or later, that defense is going to come up. And when they come up, that's when you throw it over the top.
Screen play is on. Swallowed up behind the line of scrimmage.
Well, we see it more and more. Football thrown behind the line of scrimmage. They do it that time. Nice catch, but a loss of yards on the play.
Ben Roethlisberger takes a look down from under center. Third and nine. Needs to get rid of it. And they sack the quarterback. And that's a quick series, a three and out.
Nice job that time by the defense getting the sack. The blitz was well-timed. And when it's well-timed, the offense doesn't have time to react, and they get a good sack.
The Steelers turned the ball over on down.
Fourth and long, you got so little chance of having success in a situation like this. I only have one question. Why did you go for it?
Two
tight ends.
First and 10. He'll fire it out to the left.
Pass is made, but the hit knocks the ball out. Incomplete.
Let's just tell it like it is, Jim Nance. His receiver is not a very tough guy because he gets hit. It should have been a complete pass, but he gets hit. He just throws that football on the ground, and the pass is incomplete.
Two tight ends, second and 10. He's looking long.
What a tough throw and catch into a tight spot right there for the touchdown. But today's game, these players are so good that you have to throw it in traffic. They've got to make the catch. That time he did.
The Steelers set to return the kick. He's a dangerous returner, and he'll have a chance to show you right here. And the tackle's made right around the 26-yard line. Let's go now to Danielle Bellini, who has the injury update. Let's get the injury report from Danielle Bellini.
Guys, I had a chance to speak with a Bears team official. They're saying it's just a minor injury, so he should be back on the field pretty quickly.
Getting sacked.
Pressuring the quarterback. That's what you love to do in the NFL from the defensive side. That time, the blitz, it was quick, it was fast, and they get a sack on the quarterback.
Second down coming up. Handoff. They break through. Tackle them behind the line.
Well, Jim, that didn't fool the defense at all. Second down, you run the football, hoping to make it third and short. Then you lose yards, third longs. They're hard to get in the NFL.
That last play was a run. Third down coming up.
Roethlisberger, play action.
Jim, when you get in these situations, there's not much you can do. Third long, not easy to pick up first downs in these type of situations.
Two-minute warning looms, and this may be the last play before it hits.
That's a failed conversion, but you might as well look at it like a turnover. It's going back the other way.
Find a way to score. That's always the mantra with every team when they get in the red zone. If you punch it in here, even though you're down by more than seven, it'll give you confidence for the rest of the game.
First down, offense readying for the snap.
To the right, and they score again here to pad the lead.
That was just an awful job, wasn't it, by the defense? I mean, it's first and goal. Well, you know it's going to be a run, or I think you should be playing run. The defense not ready. They get overpowered, and they give up the running touchdown.
Bears ready to kick the football. Will run this one back. And the tackle's made right around the 25-yard line. Potchery is a receiver in the slot. He had no time to get set. Bells lined up behind his quarterback as the single back. Trying to work that left side. Incomplete.
Nice job that time by the wide receiver on the post route. He's open, but the quarterback throws it too far and misses it.
Potchery is lined up in the slot. Third and 10. Throws to the right. Ball is caught. The tackle was made, but the first down is picked up.
You know, when you throw the football like that down the field, you pick up a first down, now you can do anything you want on the offensive side, and you've got that defense guessing.
into the air here on first down.
Airing it out.
But they can't connect. He had an open receiver that time and just misfired on the deep throw.
Yeah, I think he got too excited. The fact that he saw a receiver down the field wide open, he got excited. That's why he overthrew it just a little bit.
Ben Roethlisberger takes a look down from under center.
On second and 10.
Working that left side.
And he was wide open.
Out to the 23.
Another name for the fly route, the go route. It's a streak. And that means they want you to be a blue streak, run as fast as you can, get by that defense, and make a big play.
That long gain sets them up here on this play.
Let's go.
They're going back up top. Throwing now to his left. Ball's picked off. They've got him down there. Come to the line, and it's first down. He's looking to the right here on this throw. Brings it in. The Bears are going to burn the first of their three timeouts right here. This play set up by the long gainer. He'll fire it out to the left. Interception. Good piece of tackling.
Good job that time by the defense. Not being fooled. Being in position. When you're in position, you have a chance to make the play. That time they did. They got the interception.
Let's go.
Prevent defense here, trying to avoid the deep pass. Throws the pass. Got a hand on it, and it's incomplete.
Oh, this safety has so much talent. He's got the speed. He's got smarts. Got in great position and just swatted that football away.
Bells in the backfield, single back set.
On second and 10.
Looks to his left. Ball's going to be incomplete. A hit knocked the ball out.
Well, they always say if you get your hands on the football, you got to make the catch. Yeah, right. The guy that made that rule up wasn't getting hit as he was trying to catch the football. Nice hit. That time by the defender.
Third down here. Offense trying to pick up the first. The throw to the left. That catch good for a first down.
This is where games are won and lost. Once an offense gets down the red zone, even though they're down more than seven, can you find a way to punch it in there for the touchdown and not settle for a field goal?
That reception gave them the first down. They're going to get him here for a sack.
That's an excellent job by the defense. Just gets quick penetration in there, hits the quarterback, and gets the sack. That clock keeps moving. What a job by the defense in this situation.
One more snap in halftime. He sends the halfback in motion. Under fire all day.
Well, if your offensive line's not good enough just to stop the pass rush, then you got to help them out. How do you do that? Well, you keep the tight end in, let him be an extra blocker, and you tell your running backs to help out too, blocking some of these defensive linemen.
Now set up at the 32. Defense comes to the line, ready to pounce on that quarterback one more time. Can they get another sack right here? A takeaway. That's the end of the first half, and you've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. We're back here now in this one where the Bears are leading by 35. Touchback.
Come on,
He's lined up now as a slot receiver. Second half gets rolling now as he takes the snap.
And he's intercepted.
That'll stop the play right there.
Nice job of the defense that time. In position, they read the quarterback's eyes, and it led to an interception.
They face first down. Hester's going to secure the handoff.
They deck him in the backfield.
So many things you could do on first down, and what do you come up? You come up with that play. That was just a bad play call.
Hester's in the slot. Second and 14. Down the field.
Did not get both feet down.
Well, you must on the offensive side throw the football deep. Four times a game. That time, they're just not able to connect on the deep throw.
So the coach's challenge backfires. They'll lose the timeout, and they fail to overturn the call on the field. Hester's going to get set in the slot for this snap. Third and 14. Challenging the defenders to the right side. Rocks him with that hit, and the ball's going to fall incomplete.
Defensive coordinators love this situation, don't they? Third and long, they can do just about anything, and it's going to work, and they stop the offense that time.
Marshall. There's a receiver there, and the catch is made.
Well, once again, the offense is in the red zone. They got a big lead. I think it's up to this defense finally show a little toughness and try to stop them for once.
Here's the first snap after the big play. Matt Forte. Gain of 7.
Well, when you got a big lead, you're down near the opposing team's goal line. What do you do? Well, you know what? You line up, you run the football, and just dare the defense. Can you stop us this time, even though you know we're going to run it?
They tackle him for a loss.
Nice situation here for the offense. They're winning the football game. Now they're in the red zone. Let's see if they can come up with a play that fools the defense.
Get ready.
Third and goal at the 6. He makes the catch.
This game has been out of hand for a long time. They're down near the goal line again, and it's just up to the defense. Have some courage. Show some.
And he takes it across. It is a touchdown.
The head coach decides he wants to be the aggressor in this situation. On fourth and goal, he goes for it. Nice play call that time.
The point after is good. The Steelers set to return the kick. No return. The ball's coming out to the 20. Ben Roethlisberger takes a look down from under center. First and 10.
They're going to get him this time.
Well, it's just a race against time, isn't it? When the defense blitzes, can you get to the quarterback before he has time to recognize the blitz and throw it to a receiver?
After that sack, it's now second down and 17. That pass was hurried. Offense lines up here. Third and 17. Setting up screen. Makes the grab. On his way. He's at the 50. The 40. Someone's been injured out there. Hold on a minute.
Well, this is just the worst case scenario. You got a big lead and you get one of your players hurt. It's just the worst. And not only for the football team, but for the poor player too.
Brings it into his body.
Good job by the offense. They're in the red zone. They're down by more than seven. But the defense, can you stop them and just give up the field goal try?
After the long game, let's see what they do here. First down, throwing again. Looking for a receiver on the left side here. Touchdown, Pittsburgh Steelers.
When you're behind in the football game, drive down and score. They did that. Now the next time when they get back out there, they got to do it again. Show some patience and drive it down the field.
Lining up now for the two. Eyeing that left side. Got the touchdown, got the two-point conversion. People love to go for two in this game, don't they?
Well, they do, and you know what? Now I guess you and I just can't sit here and blast the coach for a bad decision. When you pick up the 2 points, you can't complain about what they're trying to do.
That kick came right at him, and it looks like the receiving team has recovered. On first down, halfway through the third quarter, and they sack the quarterback.
And this defensive end, Jim, he is some talent. That time, good job, makes the move, shows the speed, and gets around there and gets the sack.
And intercepted. Made.
That interception is strictly on the quarterback. When you make bad decisions, I don't care how good you can throw the football. The results, usually it's going to turn into an interception.
Bell's lined up directly behind the quarterback here. First down and 10. Here's the long throw by Roethlisberger. And it's incomplete. Outstanding coverage on the deep throw, forcing the incompletion.
That's why he's one of the best in the league. He's aggressive. He can take away short passes, but also has the speed and the ability to get back there and knock down those deep ones too.
Second down following that incompletion. He'll fire it out to the left. That catch gives them a first down. Now they take the football onto the opponent's side of the field.
When you're behind in a football game, all you know, when that football was coming towards him in the air, he knew if he caught it, he was going to take a big hit. Well, you know what? Good thing he caught it, because if he'd have dropped it, he still was going to take a big hit. Nice catch by the receiver. Anytime you get in the red zone, you want to punch it in there and get 7 points. They're being dominated today. They're down more than seven, but don't worry about it. Score here and just keep playing.
Hurry up, let's go!
Let's see what they do on first down following that huge play. Wide open for the catch.
Jim, when you get inside the other team's red zone, inside the 20-yard line, and you're down some points, you're thinking touchdown in these situations.
Bell, he's in for the touchdown.
I would bet first and goal that the offense, about 90% of the time, is going to run the football. And what do they do here? They run it and they get it done. That is power football at its best.
They'll get set, looking to convert on this 2-point try. He scrapped, put an additional 2 points on the board as they convert. Sean Sweezum readying his team for the kickoff. They're not going to risk the big return, so here's the squib kick. First down here. The give, wide to the left, breaks free. bringing the play to an end.
That's an excellent job. Just getting enough yardage to get the first down, move those chains, and keep this offense going.
Offense lining up here after picking up more than 30 on the previous play. First and 10. The Bears get a first down.
Again, the offensive coordinator has done a terrific job so far here today. He's got his team winning. They're in the red zone. Let's see how clever he's going to be on this call.
The offense is set at the line for the first down after that completion. Matt Forte gets it here.
And they're going to run it right.
The margin is increased with another touchdown.
Well, it's professional football. I don't want to hear anything about running up the score, rubbing it in. Your job is to stop the other team. It's not the coach who has the lead. So get out there and get it done. And if you won't, hey, they'll just keep on scoring.
And so they converted here on the two-point try. They line up here for the onside kick. They want that football back. The receiving team has the recovery. Go, 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 go. Ben Roethlisberger takes a look down from under center, looking to the right side and throwing. Gain of 17.
That's a nice job by the offense there. Get the first down. Keep those chains moving. Give yourself three more opportunities.
Bell's lined up as the single back. Throws it in the end zone. Touchdown.
What a terrible job by the defense. That time, nobody even covers the receiver. He is wide open down the field, and hey, nice job by the quarterback going through his progression. He finds the open guy and gets a touchdown pass.
Well, this works out about 40% of the time if you look back on history, and they'll go for that two-point conversion. Looking for an open. So from 2 yards out, they get it across and secure two extra points. They want the football back as they line up now in an onside kick formation. The onside kick is turned away, and the receiving team has it. The Bears are getting set for their next possession. Matt Forte lined up in the backfield. Brandon Marshall brings it in. And as the third quarter comes to a close off Lake Michigan, we'll take a short break before beginning the fourth here in Chicago. They've got a first down now after that catch.
Going for the deep ball, but it's incomplete.
Well, for some reason, this quarterback likes to keep trying to go deep down the field against this cover two. That's not the spot you want to go. You want to look underneath or right down the middle.
Hester's a receiver in the slot. They'll go ground. Troy Polamalu is all over the field.
The defense has got to be a little aggressive here. Your team is down. You've got to attack this offense. You don't want them to get in there and get another score.
Third and short. Throws to the right. Another touchdown to increase the lead.
What a good job by the wide receiver. Just going up and attacking the football. And you know why they can attack those footballs? Because they know they can't be hit. They're defenseless, so they get a free chance.
That hurts. The two-point try is denied. Robbie Gold ready to kick it. And
and he'll start his return.
And they crash into him, ending the return at the 20-yard line.
Here comes the training staff as we've got a player down on the field.
Well, that's going to hurt him tomorrow. There's no doubt about it. When you get hit like that, you're going to feel some of that pain tomorrow. But the good news is, I think he's going to be okay. And once he gets a little situated there, I think he'll be back in the game.
Roethlisberger going down the field. Hauls it in deep down the middle.
It's one thing to be able to throw the football that high and far, but it's another. He found the right receiver to throw to and put it right on the mark.
Bell's lined up now as the running back behind the quarterback. And the quarterback is taken down.
I'm just going to give the defense a lot of credit for all these sacks they've got here today. They take him down one more time. When you got this much talent on the defensive side, you're going to sack the quarterback.
Plenty of defensive backs out on the field for this one. That ball is picked off. They bring him to the turf.
That was an awesome job by the defense. They just read the quarterback's eyes. They got in position, and they made the interception.
Adam Podlish is ready to punt this one. For a touchback. Ben Roethlisberger takes a look down from under center. First and 10. He wants to go deep. And it's incomplete. They went for the deep throw, but the defensive back was there.
Yeah, good job that time. I got to give the defensive back a lot of credit. He was not caught sleeping out there. He was alert, read the right keys, and he was right with the receiver to knock down that deep throw.
The Steelers come to the line with a bunch set. Second and 10. He's looking to the right here on this throw. Tackle's made.
When you spy the quarterback, what it does, it just makes it easier to throw the football and complete those passes. Less people covering the receivers down the field.
First down following the long play. Trying to work that left side. And that ball's nearly picked off, but he dropped it.
Play doesn't even have time to develop. The quarterback is under so much pressure, he's throwing it before these receivers are even ready.
Brown's lined up in the slot. Second down and 10, working that left side. Interception. Stacked up at that point.
I have to say, that's just a terrible decision by the quarterback there. He's got to know when you're in a situation like this, you just cannot make that type of pass.
Adam Podlish is ready to punt this one.
Oh, it's a fake!
Challenging the defenders to the right side and throws it incomplete.
Well, these are the kind of throws in the NFL, Jim. You just take for granted that if it's open, you are going to hit it. But the quarterback makes a big mistake, leads the receiver too far to the inside, and it goes incomplete.
After the incomplete pass, it brings up second down. And he is brought down at the 39. Hester's lined up now as a slot receiver.
Loads it up. It's going deep.
Unstoppable. The 10, touchdown.
You got to take advantage of situations like this. Not often in the NFL do you get somebody this wide open. Good job by the receiver. Nice job by the quarterback seeing him. And what do you get? An easy touchdown pass.
The Steelers set to return the kick. Here's the kick, and this one's just a little squib kick, and they get to him at the 45. Bells lined up in a single back formation. First and 10. Stands in the pocket, and he's thrown to the ground.
The name of the game is hit the guy with the football, isn't it? That's what it is. The quarterback has it. The defensive end, what a nice play. Gets to him that time and gets the big hit.
Kotcheries in the slot. Into the open flat. Antonio Brown with the catch. The tackle by Charles Tillman.
Good job by the play caller that time, calling for the short pass. Even though it comes up short of the first down, it opens up many things that you can do on third. You can run a reverse, draw plays, screen plays, or if you want, you can still throw it down the field.
Quarters formation here for the defense.
Two.
Third down and 12. Incomplete, almost going in the other direction.
Jim, when you get in these situations, there's not much you can do. Third long, not easy to pick up first downs in these type of situations.
Ben Roethlisberger takes a look down from under center. Looking to the right side and throwing. So that's not going to get it done here. And the offense is going to turn it over on downs.
2 minute warning.
Matt Forte lined up in the backfield. To Marshall. And it falls incomplete.
They call that the moment of truth. It's a beautiful throw down the field, but the defensive back, he waits until it's time to make that jump. He defends the pass. What a good job by the defensive back.
And second and 10. Now cutting to the right side, looking for some open space. This is third down. Setting up a little screen. Has the first down and a whole lot more. The blowout continues. Another touchdown. That may have been the clincher right there.
Yeah, what a game all day long. So exciting to end it like this late in the game. Man, you enjoy victories like this.
They're setting up return. And he's out across the 20 and tackled at the 21. Well, we're anxious to hear the full story on that injury. Let's go down to Danielle Bellini with the story.
Guys, I had a chance to speak with a Steelers team official. Troy Polamalu's injury seems to be relatively minor, or at least it's minor enough that he'll be back on the field shortly.
First and 10. Here's the long throw by Roethlisberger. Oh, that could have been intercepted, but he couldn't hold on.
When you see this cover two defense as a quarterback, you got to know where to throw the football. That time, he did not make a good decision. You got to throw it sometimes deep down the middle. The safeties are not there. They're outside. He did not take advantage of that coverage that time.
Ben Roethlisberger takes a look down from under center, and he's forced to the ground.
The offensive line did a terrible job that time, reacting to the blitz by the defense. They let the defenders come free, and they sacked the quarterback.
Third and 20. Looking for an open receiver on the right. Forces a three and out.
Defensive coordinators love this situation, don't they? Third and long, they can do just about anything, and it's going to work. And they stop the offense that time.
The defense comes out of the nickel. The Steelers now move the chains. Oh, we've got an injured player on the field.
I think you can just tell by the body language and the way he's acting, that is an upper body injury. Hope it's not severe. We'll let you know as soon as we find out.
Let's go.
Ben Roethlisberger dropping back in shotgun formation.
It's intercepted!
Going to take it the distance.
The 20, the 10.
Nobody was going to catch him there. Touchdown. That touchdown might just wrap it up.
Yeah, it sure will, Jim. It's been an exciting game all day, and to score late in the game like this, to put it away, it's time to celebrate a little on the sideline.
That's a timeout call. Bears ready to kick the football. This kick will stay on the ground, avoiding a ball is out. It's James Anderson in on the tackle.
Oh, that was close, wasn't it? The return team, they don't block anybody, but very fortunate to recover their own fumble.
Bells lined up behind his quarterback as the single back. Now first and 10. Play action. Throws to the right. Had it for a moment, but the ball is knocked out incomplete.
Well, it's so hard to do this nowadays, to jar the football out of the hands of the receiver, but the defender did it that time. He hit him. That football came loose. Incomplete pass.
Potchery is going to get set in the slot for this snap. Second and 10. Fakes the throw. Still has it. The defense gets a sack.
Well, you got to know, when you're going to pump fake, you got to pump fake, reset. You got to let that football go. That time, the quarterback hesitated just a little bit, and that's all the defense needed to get the sack.
Ben Roethlisberger takes a look down from under center. Third and forever. Set up screen and complete. He'll be brought down, but not before picking up the first down.
Jim, years ago, you never would have seen a screen pass on third down, but offenses are so varied now, you see it more and more. That was nice execution on that play, and it picked up a first down.
All right, Phil, before we go, tell me about the atmosphere down in that winning locker room right now.